Hi everyone, welcome back to our mini tutorial series. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to use a tool called Degree Explorer. So Degree Explorer, or DEX, is a super useful tool that you can use to plan out your degree and program requirements. And you can actually access this from ACORN by going to the Planning Tools tab. Here, you'll be able to see a brief snapshot of your degree progression, as well as the completion of your specific programs. But when you click on it, you'll be asked to log in again, and you'll be taken to this main dashboard. So here you can get more detailed information about the completion of your requirements. So as you can see, you'll be able to see the start of your either program or your degree, as well as its completion status. If you click Show Details, you'll be able to specifically see all the requirements that you have completed, as well as the ones that you have yet to complete. So here, for example, as you can see, I haven't yet completed the 20 degrees that I need to graduate. But I have completed, for example, requirement 3, which states that I need at least 6 FCE from the 300 plus level, or that I've completed my breadth requirements. This function is super useful as it allows you to know exactly which requirements are still pending to complete your degree or your program. And here it's exactly the same thing for your programs. You'll be able to see the ones that you have completed and the ones that you need to complete in the upcoming years. Another really cool function of Degree Explorer is the planning tool. So when you click on it, you'll be taken to this page. So here you can add courses and see how they can help you satisfy degree or program requirements. It's a really super tool to plan out your degree, and you can create multiple combinations and multiple plans. So for example, to create a new plan, you would just click here. I'll name this one test plan, and then just create your plan. So as you can see, the courses that I've already completed will show up on the plan. But to add a new course, you simply click on the session that you want to take the course in. So for example, fall 2021, and enter the course code. You'll just add the course, and there it is. Sometimes, for example, if I add this course, you can get certain issues when adding the course to your plan. So here, for example, this course is problematic. To find out why, you can just hover over the course and it will tell you why. So here, the problem is that the course is not offered in the fall. So I can just drag it, take it to the winter, and the course is added in the plan, no problem. You can have issues for a variety of reasons, including missing prerequisites or co-requisites, course exclusions, and session requirements. But you should always, always double check with the official Faculty of Arts and Science calendar to be sure. As well, if you ever need a reminder of what the colors mean, you can just click on View Course Status Definitions, and you'll be able to see that greens are all the completed courses. For example, if a course was in blue, it means that it's currently in progress. I don't have any right now because I'm not enrolled in summer. Then the important feature is that once you've added courses to your plan, you can scroll down and click Reevaluate Changes. And then you'll be able to see how those courses affect your degree and program requirements. So for example, PSL 404, one of the courses that I added, allowed me to complete the requirements for my minor, and the program was then assessed as complete. If you click Show Details, you can see specifically which requirement it fulfilled, and it shows that it's a potential course, so that you haven't completed it yet, but that it would allow you to satisfy your requirements. Just as a note, always double check your degree and program completion status with your registrar, because they're the only ones that will be able to confirm your eligibility for graduation. Right, so when you've done this, an additional feature is that you can generate a PDF export, and that will fuse with your academic history, and you can have everything in the same space. But overall, these are the main two features of Degree Explorer. And as you can see, it's a super helpful tool, super useful. And hopefully this has been a useful tutorial and showed you how to use Degree Explorer and how to keep track of all your courses and requirements. You can also check out all our other mini tutorials to find out, for example, how to use the Faculty of Arts and Science timetable to find courses and how to enroll in courses when your time comes.